I'm trying to bring in people into something that I have been curious about. So it's almost like opening up this box of, here's the stuff that I've been playing with. Do you want to come play with me? I'm Betty. I am an interaction artist and designer. I'm also interdisciplinary, so I do a lot of mixed media artwork. I really like research, so I usually go and take one idea or something that I'm curious about and research the heck out of it, maybe write a lot. During the process, I like to write everything down about what I do in this project and how I've explored that topic. And then at the end, I also document it in writing. So iterative prototyping. What that means is basically anything you make, even little pieces of it, you can go and test whether it works, how people take it, because people interact with your work very differently than you expect. So what I did in one of my projects called Rainmaking on Mars, I interviewed people who were planning to go to Mars on a one-way trip forever. And I decided I'm gonna make this project with them. So every single little prototype that I made, I would go back to this person, Skype them, and hopefully even in person, have them use it, try it, and just have them talk to me about it. And so that really transformed the project. I think about the future and I think about what could be the next thing of interaction. What if there was something that could imagine these gestures as a more outgoing way of speaking about yourself, and then that's why we made this costume that kind of moves and can sense all of that. Micro gestures is such a mundane thing. It's almost like breathing. You never notice it, but you come away from somebody who has spoken to you in a certain way with a certain gesture, and you just feel a specific way. And I think that's something that I'm just obsessed with. I do a lot more collaboration now than before. And when I'm collaborating with people, you really can't control it as much as you want to. So when I was doing my thesis, and that was the Xmas-y dress, we were three people, but two people with theses that we were doing, and there were two kind of different ideas, but we had some commonalities and thought that we could work together, and we both had to be open enough to let the idea change for it to become itself, because sometimes your ideas become what they are on their own, and as an artist, it's also an art to kind of let that go and just let something become the way it should be. Every project that you've probably seen is something that I had to learn on the spot to make that project happen. I'm definitely in a learning phase right now. Now, I think my philosophy is a bit more about maybe just feeling like I have explored that topic. So I think all of it is about the fact that I'm curious about humans in general and the interactions and how we communicate messages to each other.